Hello friends, how are all of you? This is your friend Manak from Civil Center, and I welcome all of you back to our channel and another video on Tekla Structural Designer. So friends, in today's video, we'll discuss and we'll show you how to design pile caps and pile in Tekla Structural Designer. So as you all know, in pile, we have two components, that is the pile itself and the pile cap. So in this particular software, we can design the pile cap, but we can't design the pile. So let's find out the procedure. So first of all, we'll go to our foundations and then we'll go to our catalogs. And after going to the catalogs, we'll add a new data here. Suppose I want to name it as P1 and I can just choose the type of pile. Let's give it driven and shape also. I can just choose between circular and square. Dimension, we can change to any dimension we want. Let's say 400 mm. Length also we will be able to change, let's say 7 meter. Embedment, that also we can change. And the load transfer type, whether we want to provide a friction pile, whether you want to provide end bearing pile, so you can change that. And after that, you can just change the pile capacity. If you have the soil test reports, then you can find this values, the axial compressive resistance and the axial tensile resistance of the pile. You can just change it to whatever values you find. So now we have the vertical linearity. You can just change it, the linear or non-linear, and stiffness also, vertical stiffness also you can change. Horizontal restraint, you can keep it as fixed or spring linear. So I'll just click on OK from here, and this one particular pile type has been created here. And you can notice that we can add more number of piles if you want. So now we'll just keep as one. You can use multiple piles as per your preference, or also you can edit this using this option. So let's just click on OK here. And before assigning the piles, we'll check out settings for the pile caps. So as we, in the settings, as we can see here, we have settings for our foundations. We'll go to isolated footings and then reinforcement layout. So we have two options, so pad base and pile cap. So we'll select pile cap here, and here we all have all the settings. So minimum loose bar size, so I'll just take FE500, and minimum loose bar size is 12 mm. Okay, and maximum loose bar size FE500, and then your, let's say 20 mm, and then okay. So this minimum principal bar spacing and maximum secondary bar spacing, these things also you can change here. And next is your pile cap minimum depth, maximum depth, depth increments, all this you can change. General parameters, you can find your nominal aggregate size and ignorable passive pressure, and then the piles. So the piles, the minimum number of piles for pile caps and columns is 2. You can change that, and also the minimum pile edge distance and everything you can change. So after making those changes, you just click on save, yes, and then okay. So your settings have been saved. Now you have to simply select your pile cap column. After selecting this, you don't need to change anything here, except we have the soil test report and you want to change your particular soil unit weight, you can do that. The rest they will take automatically, as we had changed the bar size in the design settings. You don't need to change it from here. So we'll simply assign it the piles. As you can see, piles and the pile cap has been assigned. Now it has not been designed, so it can be designed using a single click. Just click on design pile caps. So after clicking on design pile caps, as you can see, the pile has been designed. And if you want to just check out the details here, you can just click on it and then right click on it, and you can just click on design member, and here you have the designs. As you can see, we have the concrete cover here is mentioned here, pile capacity summary, 3D building analysis, and everything has been mentioned here in this. So suppose you want to just check out the details here, you can just right click on it then click on generate detailing drawing, and let's say you can just change this. And so the drawing will open in your particular CAD software. So as you can see, the details of the pile, 16 mm bars have been used, and total mass of the reinforcement have also been mentioned here. So we have the size of 1700 into 700 of the two piles, and the reinforcement provided in the Y direction is 16 mm reinforcement and the spacing of 200 mm center to center. And along the X direction, they have provided reinforcement of 16 mm at the rate 200 center to center. And the depth of this pile, particular pile gap, that is all this pile gap which I have selected is 450 mm. So like this, you can just generate the drawing of one particular member. And if you want to generate the drawing of all the members, you can just go to the drawing here and then drawing management. And then you can just select the foundation layout and you can just click on content here. You want to select the bluish foundation, that is the base which you have created, and then okay, and then view drawing, and then okay. So we'll have here the total foundation layout, as you can see here, total foundation layout with all the sizes and all the reinforcement details, as you can see here. So like this, friends, we can design the pile foundation. So if you have any doubts in this particular software, you can connect with us. You can just register using the link which has been given in the description as well as in the comment box, because we provide training to professionals as well as students. And we take advanced classes for this particular software. So if you want to get trained from us, you can contact us, and you can stay connected to us in YouTube for videos on this particular software, other softwares related to civil engineering, and many other concepts which interesting concepts in civil engineering. Stay tuned with us and keep commenting. Bye bye.